Welcome to Orth Plays Baldur's Gate 2, Throne of Bhaal. When last we left off, we had just defeated the priestess Diatha in Sendai's enclave. And we're proceeding further in. This is a familiar spectator beholder, Ken. That was pretty simple. I'm not going to find the nearest hive and check out the ladies. So, yeah.
Diatha is dead, and the rogue boss spawn draws ever closer. Mythical, my mind flayer ally. You must stop the fool before this goes further. Do not wave your tentacles at me, Mythikil! I have no other choice. My minions are slaughtered. Even my priestess has been destroyed. If you wish to feast on the brains of those that fall in slaves, you will unleash your illithid on the bald child that invades the enclave. You must not allow the interloper to reach my inner sanctum.
Heck, my illithid. And everyone look. A short bowstring. Ah. Well, unless it can be added to the guessin bow, it is unfortunately not very useful. And gets another 9th level spell slot, which is to say another 10th level spell slot. Good. Now let's see. But now I'll take Dragon's Breath again.
Orders?
Not mythical. That is just an Olatharid.
Ready. What's our plan?
Yes.
Get over here unless you want your stone skin dispelled, sweetie.
Listening.
And I have been intellect range and I'm currently very stupid.
What do you want?
You have my attention.
So, given that any illithid could kill me in one hit, I am not quite stupid enough to continue until this wears off.
What?
Liquid mercury. Well, Sespinar has mentioned that, all right. And yeah, I don't think I need those anymore. Possible I will encounter another magic golem, but even if I do, Eerie not being able to attack it won't be a big problem. Vampiric illithid, yikes.
Yes? I fear nothing.
You point, I punch. Where Minsk goes, east.
Orders? What do you wish? I'm listening.
I've been forgetting to do this lately because of so many combatants immediately. Another vampiric illithid, mythical, two more ulitharids, and an umber hawk.
You've got my attention.
Well, one of those means that those of us who can't be immune to level drain should stand back. Yep, it's another vampiric illithid. Back to your anti-vampire weapons, Minsk and Sarah.
Take the life she gave!
And Saravak is stunned.
Orders? Got it.
Something up? Right you are.
I'm listening.
Time to move? All right.
Cannot see me. Mythical can.
You have my attention.
What can I do?
Swords, not words!
Luckily, they kept trying to get to Saravak because he was stunned, and they couldn't.
You have my attention.
And that's that. Oh, how much XP was mythical worth? $19,000, just like a standard Olatherid. Well, while we're waiting for the cloud to clear, we'll go talk to Sespinar. Powerful regeneration ring, and Is anyone else injured? Looks like no, so Minsk might as well wear the weaker regeneration ring for now. Situation where a short bowstring could only be used on a longbow? Either way. That's quite a long sword. Wonder if anyone wants to use it. And scimitar, again, immunity to level drain. Question is, do I want Jahira to use that instead of Ixel's nail? Do I still have a powerful shield, or did I sell it? I don't think that's the one I'm thinking of, but I know I have another one there, yes. Sure, why not? Instead of, no, possibly instead of that, though. His strength is 25, so that does nothing. So now he's sticking with the Mace of Disruption.
My army has been slaughtered, falling helplessly before your might. You would have made a great ally to our cause. Alas, the time for such possibilities is past.
Well, I mean, we could at least discuss what your motivation is, Sendai.
But the lives of my servants and slaves have not been spent in vain. They have bought me time to prepare a special surprise for you. Prepare to meet your end, boss.
I get that a lot. Guard captain, she called, Stell.
Here.
The crown rules supreme.
My
place is the of icy breath.
Name it.
You have my attention.
Summon a death.
Your workshop. Saravak stands
ready and raring to go. Great master,
you are fighting.
Alia.
Got my attention.
The weapon doesn't matter.
Don't seem to be very tough.
By all that is decent, I fight! You need something? I'll do it. Something else?
Who says? What?
Death comes from me. Feel its icy breath.
Wizard each time one of the statues. Seems to have a different class.
You have my attention. Show me.
You point, I punch.
I'm on it. Orders?
Evil cannot be allowed to fester.
Die! Death comes. Feel its icy breath.
My weapon does nothing.
Race.
Nature,
Swords, not words!
Definitely need true sight now. So that she's really hard to hit.
You need something?
And my true seeing isn't working on her, which might be more of a problem. Well, I know I've got more wands of spell strike. Imowen apparently does not have one.
Has no effect!
Ack, Paul and Dave.
from my very soul! Damn you! But I may yet rob you of the glory of your victory!
Rather you didn't.
Know this. Even as I die, the return of our father is inevitable. Though I fall, the others will ensure Bhaal is reborn.
Why would you even want to?
I greet you once again, Godchild. The second of your revelations awaits me.
Much as I would love to say that, it would not do any good.
Good. I hope you have pondered your origin, for any being of great power must know much of themselves before they can put reason to their actions. Let us continue. This time we are not concerned with your past, Godchild. Now we will look into your present. The prophecy proceeds towards its climax, as I am sure you are well aware. Your place in this prophecy is what is in question, perhaps. This question will be answered this once, by yourself.
Why am I here? Answer me.
I would never refer to myself as spawn of Bhaal.
You are here to tell yourself of the prophecy and your own place in it. Knowledge of yourself brings power, Godchild, and control over your destiny. Ponder what advantage can be derived here if you wish. Listen as you speak.
So, this is a copy of myself that I addressed so long.
It is a piece of you. Perhaps from another time, another dimension. But you, nevertheless. Speak to yourself of Orlando's prophecy, I bid you.
Yes, I suppose it makes sense. I was once taught of the prophecy in this way, wasn't I? It only makes sense that I would do it myself in the future.
If I get called upon to explain the prophecy to a past version of myself, I am going to be so much more sarcastic than this guy.
Listen closely. You are the center of the prophecy, but not in the way you think. You bring murder to all you touch. That is true. The ones you hate, the ones you help, even the ones you love. This is part of your nature.
Thus do we see that all CRPG protagonists are children of Bhaal.
But this is not what the prophecy speaks of. The Bhaal spawn shall bring chaos and destroy much of Faerun. But this is not done by you. You have already killed several of those Bhaal spawn who the prophecy speaks of. Those who would bring this destruction. You bring death, yes. Is nothing like what they would do. They are successful. You are here to stop them. Whether you intend to or not, you exist to prevent the prophecy from coming true. The prophecy warns of your failure, not of you. I felt as you do once. Brace yourself for what comes next.
You will be continually attacked by extremely powerful siblings and their minions. I know that's a complete shock to you.
You have been counseled by your own self. You are now aware of your place in these events and why you are here. Not every soul gets such an opportunity.
Unfortunately, the actual offered sarcastic options get you evil points, so.
Then there is but one more question before you may return to your path. When you return to the waking world, you will continue to speed towards your purpose, stopping the prophecy from coming true. My question, why do you do this? Perception is truth in this one instance, Godchild. Consider what you have learned, and farewell.
combat. Leveled from killing those.
Yes. What do you wish?
Another greater whirlwind attack.
We are all heroes. You and Moo and I. Hamsters and rangers everywhere. Rejoice!
Karanak Swing will not let me teleport around constantly. The ones are worth picking up. Oh, those don't stack. That's not a potion of superior healing. That's a potion of heal. Well then. Useful, but still, well, Imowen couldn't wear it, only Saravok in our party could wear it, and he is not going to. I prefer him not mind controlled, thank you. Lots of potions of superior healing. If any of the statues have gear unique enough to merit picking up. That'd be one no. Airy leveled as a cleric. She can learn to summon a planetary. And she gets a new 7th level spell slot too. were Barzagoth. There we go. And from here, we'll probably deal with the next challenge in my pocket plane next, but for right now, I'll wrap up this video here. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.